You seem like you've become a different fighter with motherhood. And I know for a while, and I'm sure she still does, Michelle Waterson, you know, was all about mom champ, being the mom champ, being the mom champ. You're really, really close to being the first mom champ. What could you even imagine what that would be like?
Yeah, it's crazy. Like on the down low, you know, they're like talking about Amanda Nunes and stuff like that she was a mom champ
Right,
and
right.
like that, you know. So and like we just had Lauren Murphy, who is a really good friend of mine. She just fought for it, you know. So I'm really just hoping that they have more mom champs, you know. If I'm the first, like the one that's like gave birth, you know, definitely will be, man, I think will be a big inspiration for a lot of people. I think we'll be like, man, we'll be kind of showing my story, and I think a lot of people will be able to identify themselves because one of the biggest my daughter's
I hear. That's who you're fighting for, right?
Yes, definitely. Say
Hi.
hi.
Hey.
Well, definitely, kind of just as soon as I found out I was pregnant, you know, it was a big, not shock, you know, of course, because you know what you're getting yourself into and when you're doing stuff. But I thought, like, man, my career is, I lost sponsors, I lost fans, I lost like a lot of things I didn't know. People saying, like, oh, you're not going to come back, you know. So I think would be kind of like not a comeback story because I was never down. The pregnancy would never make me down. But just to show how we can, a mom can be like at the highest level of mixed martial arts, you know. This is like not amateur fight, you know, we're the best of the best there and be the champ of that, you know. So I think we'll be really, I'll feel more like, okay, everything happened for a reason, and yeah, that's what it was supposed to be, you know. And just be more confident in my decisions with everything of coming back early. Okay, maybe kind of opening my hand to maybe I could lose, you know, when I came back 4 months, you know. Of course, I went in to win, but of course, coming back 4 months after pregnancy, you know that the chances to lose are a little bit higher than if you didn't, you know, if you waited longer or something like that. So just trying to do it and get better and evolving and show everybody wrong, and I think will be a big like statement and how much people can really accomplish in their lives if they focus on it and really try it. This is, I will, after this fight, we'll like try to renegotiate my contract. So it's good. You're gonna see some numbers, kind of what kind of numbers I bring in. I think a lot of like, you know, people who don't really watch the UFC, the main event, they're gonna see who it is, you know? So I'm really excited just kind of to show who Mackenzie is to the people who maybe who didn't know me before. And try to show my jiu-jitsu, you know, keep that, you know, I'm fighting Marina Rodriguez, she's a striker, so I really want to show the efficiency of jiu-jitsu in this match. You know, a lot of people say, oh, you want to be like showing your striking, you know, not really, you know, not right now, you know. I'm ready, I'm prepared to go 5 rounds, all the rounds if we need to go standing up. I feel confident, I think my hands will help me go to the ground, but man, I think the way to beat the striker is the grappling, especially if that's my strength, you know? So I'm really excited for this fight.
I know you're not looking past Marina, but I also know that you have a contract coming up and you're also really close right now into that title picture. How far do you look ahead that, you know, one more fight, you're right there, and I know they're going to be fighting the rematch real soon. So it times out very well.
Yeah, no. This fight is, for me, it's like a belt, you know. I'm fighting this fight like a title match, you know. I know it's not worth the title, but for in my mind it's worth the title because this is like do or break or make, you know, this fight. So hopefully I can be watching Rose and Zhang Weili like front row as the next contender of the winner of them. So I think next month, right, November 6th. And yeah, I'm gonna give everything to really show there will be like 5 wins, straight wins. And I think depending how it goes, maybe if I win but kind of get punched a few times and have some holes still that we would like to work, maybe do one more fight. But if it's like a perfect performance and everything, like, you know, we couldn't change anything, then for sure we'll definitely call for that belt after this fight. So it's really, really important.
When you look at the two that are fighting for the title, Rose and Whaley, is there one of those that you would rather face? Or how do you feel you stack up against either of them?
I think I think this fight will be good to tell me how old you will them, you know, because of Marina, she's longer than me. She's a little bit similar to Rose, who's a little bit taller and kind of has her kicks and her punches, heavy hitter and things like that. But they both have some ground game. I think that's always harder, you know, as a grappler. I prefer to fight someone like Marina, who's more just total striking, you know, like almost very little ground game, than the people who kind of know what they're doing. And I think Zhang Weili, she has a judo background, so like a good base. It's a little bit harder to take down. And even when you're on the ground, they kind of know what they're doing. And Rose too, she does some flying arm bars, some things like that. So definitely I'm confident with my ground against anybody, but I think to see how I'll do with Marina will kind of tell me, hey, maybe I prefer to fight someone a little bit shorter, like Zhang Weili. I don't know. I do good, like, closing the distance with someone like Rose. But, yeah, I'm prepared to fight for both. I think both would be a great match.